Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools that you cannot afford to miss, and they'll change your life. Have you ever thought about building anything? And when I say anything, I mean anything your mind can imagine using AI. Before, you'd need to be a master coder, a budding developer that studied for years. But now, for the first time ever with this first tool, you can create any idea you have in your head, and you don't need to know a line of code. Even though this app will show you code, you don't need to program it. It's insane. Now, I'd like to say at this point, do not get scared by the word code. You will not need to code. This app will do it for you, and I'll show you how easy it is. Okay, so first of all, go to the link down below and download it for free right here to run on your operating system. Works on Windows, Mac, Linux, whatever you've got, Cursor will load. Okay, once you've downloaded it, all you have to do is open Cursor, and you'll see you've got a very simple interface. Open a folder is the first thing you need to click. So I'll create a folder. So I've created a folder called Creator Magic, and now I get this interface. So how do we get this Cursor Composer working for us? Let me show you step by step so you can do this yourself. First of all, you'll go to the top search bar here and you'll click Show and Run Commands. You can also access it with Shift, Command, or Control and P. And then type in Composer, and you'll see you've got Enable and Disable Composer. Make sure you've clicked Enable Composer. With that done, all we need to do is create a simple text file. And you can do this by right-clicking and select New Text File. Inside this text file, I'm going to write in natural language what I want my app to do. This is going to be extremely simple for my example. The app will visit my website, news.creatormagic.ai, look at the latest posts. It'll compose posts for X, brackets Twitter, about AI tools mentioned, and give me a button to copy the text to the clipboard. Once I've written my instructions, I'll just go to File and I'll Save As, and I'll call this file readme.txt. Okay, that's now saved in my Creator Magic folder. This is where I access Composer and get it to do all the work for me. And to access Composer, it's Command or Control on a PC and I, and you get this little interface down here at the bottom. Now, I can hit Command and Plus to make this all much bigger so you can see what's going on here, and I'm going to type some instructions to my Cursor Composer. Watch this. And I'm going to write, develop and create the necessary files for my app and design a sleek modern web page for usage. You'll notice it's using GPT-4o, but I can change to Claude 3.5 Sonnet if I like, or any other model that is available with Cursor. Then I just hit enter and I sit back and watch it make my app. Look at this. Absolutely incredible. In real time, it's deciding what to put into all the files. It's writing the code for me, so I don't need to know anything. And it's completed the app, and it's given me instructions on how to run it. That literally took seconds to make this very simple app. So I need to go ahead and follow instructions 1, 2, and 3 to get it working. Let's do that. We just go to Terminal, New Terminal in the menu. Don't worry, we don't need to get codey. We just copy and paste the instructions that have been provided to us by Cursor Composer. Okay, and look at that. The server appears to be running, so let's visit it by Command and clicking the address. And boom, straight away in Chrome, it's pulled in my latest post from this week with tweets for each AI tool I've mentioned in this video. All the links to the tools I'm mentioning will be down in the description below, and it'd be great if you could throw a like on this video if you're enjoying what you're watching so far. How incredible. If I want to copy to clipboard, I can click that sleek button and it says tweet is copied to clipboard. Then if I'm feeling like it, I can create a new post on X and Command V, and boom, there is my post ready to go. You can see how quickly I automated something that's pretty boring in my life using no code or low code. I mean, this is a great example of how you can start coding without any knowledge, and if you want to go deeper down the rabbit hole, you can learn on the fly. But Cursor Composer, I think, is absolutely incredible. It leverages latest LLMs such as GPT-4o and Claude 3.5 Sonnet to create apps for you, and what's more, it'll create every single file needed and even tell you the instructions to run to get it up and going. How cool is that? I can't wait to see what you create with this, and I know after this video, I'm going to sit here creating a million apps to automate my whole life. Now, talking about creating your own apps with no code whatsoever, watch this quick clip from the Lex Friedman podcast.
Maybe if you find a problem that a lot of people on Reddit already have and you solve that problem, say, I made this thing that might solve your problem and maybe it's free for now, you know, like that could work. Narrow it down. Mm-hmm. What you're building.
Time is limited.
Lex there speaking to Peter Levels, who's a serial entrepreneur who's really inspired me this week to create apps using code and AI. And he's actually created a really popular app that apparently is making him $71,000 per month called Photo AI. Now, there are many ways you can train your face into models. You can do it yourself. You can use Allura and go ahead and train the latest Flux model. And actually, Matt Wolf has created an amazing video on how exactly to do that. I'll link that video up down below, by the way, so you can go and watch it and try it out for yourself. But if you don't want to get into the nuts and bolts of training your own model, you can use Peter Level's great app. It's called Photo AI, and it's trending this week because it's in the Andreessen Horowitz Top 100 Gen AI Consumer Mobile Apps Newcomers. Photo AI is there. Let's give it a go. Okay, the cool thing to note about this app is that you can take 1,000 AI photos, you can create 5 different models every month, and it even uses the latest Flux photorealistic AI photo generator. You might remember a few weeks ago I talked about Flux. It's so realistic and so good, and it works inside Photo AI. So let's give this a go. First, I'll continue with my Google account. Now I'm going to subscribe. It's a shame, but as of right now, I'm just being asked to subscribe again, even though I've paid the fee, and none of these links seem to work for me right now. So hopefully we'll get this fixed, and I'll be able to show you in a future video. It says here, do I get access after paying? Yes, immediately after payment, you get an automated email with a login link. You can then create your first AI model and start taking photos. Creating a model usually takes around 30 minutes, and then taking a photo takes 30 seconds. Unfortunately, and I'm sure I'm an edge case, I didn't get instant access. I've messaged Peter directly on X to get help, and you can help me feature this in a future video by amplifying this message with a repost or like. Link down below. Thanks. Okay, final tool for this week is Ideogram. It was updated to version 2.0, and the unique thing about this is not only can you make these cool, realistic-looking images, but you can put advanced text in your images. Ideogram have really nailed that aspect of image generation. Let's have a look. Signing in with Google, and it introduces Ideogram 2.0, where you can generate realistic-looking images, and of course, text can go into these images. So let's start off by creating a wizard, casting a magic spell with text creator magic, and subscribe now in bold electrified letters. We can change things such as magic prompt, that's enhancing the prompt. We can change the aspect ratio, so let's make it 16:9. We can make it public or private, and we can choose the new 2.0 model. We can also change the color palette. At the moment it's on auto, but if we fancy a specific look, let's go for a magic look, that would be a good one. And then we just click generate. Take a look at these. Wow, create a magic subscribe now. Really realistic looking wizards, and incredible the way it's given us two different fonts here. This kind of text generation in an AI image model is pretty incredible. Let's go for another prompt here. We'll go for a mystical book floating in midair with AI tools inscribed in golden arcane script with unlocked power appearing in fiery red letters across the top. Let's see how prompt adherent it is. And for the color palette, we'll just go for auto on this one and generate again. And here it is, generating in real time now in front of our eyes. Wow, look at that. It goes from black and white to, yes, AI tools inscribed in golden letters. And it has indeed followed the instructions of fiery red letters, or almost red in most images, above the book. So prompt adherence is a huge thumbs up here. The ability to put text into images has now been solved, and clearly from these examples alone, we can see AI image generation and the inclusion of text is only going to get better with time. So what do we reckon? Pretty incredible stuff. The ability to code on automation without knowing a single line of code and generate apps that can help you in your content creation. The ability to train your face into an AI model and make multiple photos containing your own face in different situations. And the advanced ability to put text into images. Oh, and by the way, if you haven't had enough AI tools this week, check out the Andreessen Horowitz Top 100 Gen AI Consumer Apps 3rd Edition. It was released this week. And you can see the top 50 web products and mobile apps and a breakdown on how things are growing online. And a lot of the tools, it says here, are being used by content creators. All the links are there. And of course, I'll link to every tool I mentioned in this video down below. Make sure you subscribe to my channel for more stuff just like this. Also, I've got a weekly email about these tools. Get on that list so that you never miss an update. And of course, watch the playlist that's showing on your screen now to dive down the rabbit hole and see all the AI tools you may have missed from previous weeks on my channel.